Hey horror fans, and welcome to another episode of October Horror Fest. I have discussed horror movies and horror movie series, but today I decided to change things up and talk about a horror television series. Due to the massive success of A Nightmare on Elm Street series, New Line Cinema franchised the crazy out of it from all kinds of merchandise and so forth, so they decided to make A Nightmare on Elm Street, the TV series titled Freddy's Nightmares. Freddy's Nightmares arrived on October 8th, 1988, and was aired usually at midnight. Freddy Krueger was not the main character, but he would host every episode, and he would from time to time be part of the plot in the episode. The pilot featured Freddy being killed, and after we usually got episodes that would tell one or sometimes two horror stories per episode, and sometimes would have two-parters. The series was a low budget, so you will not see any real high-profile actors or actresses. There was an interesting theme, though. Anyone could write an episode. Anyone could direct an episode. And anyone who wanted to be in an episode could be in an episode. Man, I wish I could have been there for that. The series is hilarious, and despite some cheesy acting, you have a good time watching the series. Especially around Halloween. The series lasted only 2 years, but there was a reason for it. The show was good for horror fans, but remember, it was aired at midnight on purpose. Syndication for the show started, and the other networks didn't really care when to air the show. It aired at like 4 p.m. when kids were getting home from school. And, well, needless to say, parents weren't exactly happy, and lots of bad things went down. And the series went to the grave. Though it should be noted, due to the series' death, it allowed Tales from the Crypt to last another 2 years, so at least there's that. After doing research, I did discover some characters from A Nightmare on Elm Street series had roles in the Freddy's Nightmares episodes. Robert Englund, of course, as Freddy Krueger. Leslie Dean, who would later be in Freddy's Dead, The Final Nightmare. Burr D. Benning, who was in A Nightmare on Elm Street 5, The Dream Child. Don Maxwell, who was also in A Nightmare on Elm Street 5, The Dream Child. Clayton Landy is the last, and he was in A Nightmare on Elm Street 3, Dream Warriors. Currently, the series is not available on DVD or Blu-ray, so you will have to look for it, but it is out there and is worth the hunt. Please tune in tomorrow as I discuss another horror-related topic. This is the Entertainment Wizard, signing off.